Hello everyone, this is Mr. Suman. Welcome to Suman Education Academy. So I'll continue mechanics of solids, unit 1, simple stresses and strain problems. Problem 1, volumetric strain of a cylindrical rod. So look at here. The given question is a steel rod 5 meter long and 30 millimeter in diameter. So you can easily, you can assume everyone aware of steel rod, right? And what will be the 5 meter length that you can easily assume? And that particular 5 meter long rod is having 30 mm in diameter and which is subjected to an axial tensile load. So here pulling force is acting on it and which is equal to 50 kN. So determine the change in length. We need to calculate what is change in length, change in diameter and change in volume of the rod. So these three things we need to calculate. So that means you can expect this problem for 6 marks or sometimes for 8 marks also. Take capital E. That is equal to 2 into 10 to the power of 5 Newton per millimeter square. So Young's modulus is given and Poisson's ratio is 0.25. So let me write the given data. So solution. Let me write the given data. Here given rod is steel rod. And here the length is equal to 5 meters. So we have to convert into millimeter. So that is 5 into 10 to the power 3 millimeters. And we have diameter, which is equal to 30 millimeter, no need to convert. So when we have diameter, so we can calculate cross sectional area. That is when it is a cylindrical rod. So the area will be pi by 4 D square. So pi by 4 into 30 square. So let me calculate this. Pi divided by 4 into 30. The answer which we are getting 706.86. So area we have got, which is equal to 706.86 in terms of millimeter square. And the tensile load is given, tensile load which is denoted by P, which is equal to 50 kilonewtons. So let me convert this into newtons. So 50 into 10 to the power 3 in terms of newtons. And we need to calculate change in length, change in diameter and change in volume. But here Young's modulus is given, which is equal to 2 into 10 to the power 5 Newton per millimeter square. And also Poisson's ratio also given. So Poisson's ratio, which is denoted by mu, which is equal to 0.25. So these are the given data. But here we need to calculate. Let's calculate. Here. First, change in length we need to calculate. So first bit is change in length. Change in length and which is denoted by delta L. Second, diameter means change in diameter. Clear? Change in diameter, that is delta D. And third, we have to calculate change in volume. Change in volume. So that is delta V. So these are the three things we need to determine. So let us do one by one. First bit. Let us calculate change in length. Change in length and which is denoted by delta L. Very simple equation, general equation and very basic equation that we have to apply. So that is delta L, which is equal to PL by AE. One of the basic equation from the Young's modulus equation, that is Young's modulus is called stress by strain. So strain, which is equal to stress by Young's modulus. And here stress is load by area. So load by area into E we can write, and E is delta L by L, right? So delta L is equal to, you'll get, L will be multiplied with P. So PL by AE. So this is what the equation of change in length, right? So this equation I'm using here. So P is 50 into 10 to the power 3 into length. We have 5 into 10 to the power 3 divided by cross-sectional area is 706.86 into Young's modulus is 2 into 10 to the power 5. So let me calculate this. 50 into 5 into 10 power 6 divided by 706.86 into 2 into 10 to the power 5. So the answer is 1.768 delta L we have got, which is equal to 1.768 in terms of millimeters. So first bit is over now. First bit is over. So next, what we need to calculate? We need to calculate change in diameter. Next, we need to calculate second bit. Change in diameter. Change in diameter. So that is delta D. So here we have to change the, because I'll go with some different equations, because when Poisson's ratio is given, so easily we can calculate change in diameter. So before that, let me write here lateral strain, which is equal to change in diameter to the original diameter. So here delta D, which is equal to, we can write lateral strain into original diameter D, right? And similarly here, let me continue. Here, this lateral strain, which is also equal to mu into longitudinal strain. Longitudinal strain and into original diameter is D. How it is mu into longitudinal, let me write here. We know the equation of Poisson's ratio, which is equal to lateral strain to the longitudinal strain. Longitudinal strain. So from here, this lateral strain is, which is equal to mu into longitudinal strain. So same thing I have written here. So mu value, we have 0.25 already given in the question, into longitudinal equation is delta L by L and into D. So here, now you can see 0.25 into delta L, we have 1.768 divided by original length we have, which is original length is how much? 5 into 10 to the power 3. So 5 into 10 to the power 3 into diameter we have 30. So let me calculate this one. 0.25 into 1.768 into 30 divided by 5 into 10 to the power 3. So we are getting 0.002652. The answer is delta D, which is equal to 0.002652 in terms of millimeter. So this is second answer. Change in diameter we have got. Next, what we need to calculate? We need to calculate the change in volume. So change in volume, third bit is change in volume. So that is delta V. So diameter length that you can see only for cylindrical rod, right? So volumetric strain related to cylindrical rod. So we know all the equations. So here volumetric strain, which is equal to change in volume to the original volume. And here change in volume, which is equal to volumetric strain into original volume. So change in volume, we know the equation, that is delta L by L minus 2 times of delta D by D. Sorry, volumetric strain. Delta L by L minus 2 times of delta D by D per cylindrical rod. And into original volume is pi by 4 area into length, right? Pi by 4 D square into L. So delta L, how much we have got delta L? Here delta L 1.768 divided by length is 5 into 10 to the power 3. 5 into 10 to the power 3 minus 2 times of delta t. Just before we have calculated delta t, 0.002652. 0.002652 divided by the diameter. Diameter is given, I think, 30, yes, which is 30 into pi by 4. 30 square into length is 5 into 10 to the power 3. So let me calculate this. 1.768 divided by 5 into 10 to the power 3. So this ratio which we are getting, 3.536 into 10 to the power minus 4 minus 2 into 0.002652 divided by 30. So this one is 1.768 into 10 to the power minus 4 into 5 divided by 4 into 30 square. So already we have the area, right? That is 706.86, right? Into 5 into 10 power 3. So it is 3534291.735. So let me calculate this. 3.536 to 10 power minus 4 is 1.768 into 10 to the power. See, solving problem is very, very important. 1.768 into 10 power minus 4 we are getting into 3534291.735. 624.86. Yes, correct answer. Change in volume which is equal to 624.86 in terms of millimeter cube. So this is our final required change in volume. Right. Now first, let me write all the answers. First, we have got delta L, which is equal to 1.768 millimeter. Second, we have got change in diameter, which is equal to 0.002652, right? And third, change in volume, we have got 624.86 millimeter cube. So these are the final answers. So thank you very much. So in next class, I'll go with rectangular taper section and circular taper section. So that is a little different from this particular problems and derivations. So thank you very much, and do subscribe Suman Education Academy, and do support, like and share my videos. Thank you. Thank you so much.